everyone. Welcome back to Book Banter, presented by the Public Library of Youngstown and Mahoning County. My name is Alex, and joining me today is my friend and fellow librarian, Sarah.
Hey.
And we are going to be discussing Warrior Girl Unearthed by Angeline Boulley.
In Warrior Girl Unearthed, we follow Perry, who we saw in the companion novel, Firekeeper's Daughter, and she is looking forward to a summer of just like hanging around and, you know, going fishing and doing all the stuff that she loves, until she gets into a little accident and ruins the Jeep that her Aunt Donis gave her, and she now has to pay for the repairs. Well, to do that, she is put into an internship program, and she gets put into her tribe's museum, run by Cooper, who everyone kind of thinks is a little odd.
Quirky Cooper.
Quirky Cooper, yeah. And it's there that Perry kind of finds her calling, where she is learning all about all of the artifacts and remains of not just her tribe, but of tribes around the country that are being held by collectors and museums and schools and things like that. And she kind of makes it her mission to get these things back, no matter what.
Yeah,
and
at any cost.
At any cost, yeah. And there's, she makes some choices along the way, makes some new friends and that help her, and some that don't. But that's Warrior Girl Unearthed, and Alex and I are going to give our thumbs up or thumbs down or thumbs meh. So you ready?
Yeah.
All right. 3, 2, 1. Yes. I liked this one a lot.
Yeah.
And I really liked it as a companion novel to Firekeeper's Daughter.
Yeah. I was nervous about reading it because Firekeeper's Daughter was probably one of the top 5 reads for me last year. So I'm so nervous, but it carried its weight. I think that she did an incredible job with this one as well.
I agree. I liked seeing what happened with all the characters from Firekeeper's Daughter. We get some information on what happened with Donis and Jamie, if you did read it. Even with Levi and Stormy and all of those characters that we grew to know in Firekeeper's Daughter. But Perry and her twin Pauline also make an appearance.
They do.
In Firekeeper's Daughter. So it was nice to see how they've grown up.
Yeah.
Because this is 10 years later.
Right. So they're teenagers now.
Yeah. It was a lot of fun. I actually really examined the cover very closely on this one, because Firekeeper's Daughter, I feel like every time I look at the cover, I see something new. So I was looking at the cover a lot, and I loved, as the further I got in the book, the duality of the cover and the title referring to Perry and the set of remains they refer to as Warrior Girl.
That's interesting. I heard Angeline speak at Clee Reads about the cover that they did for Firekeeper's Daughter. So now I like need to know, because it was like so in depth and like how what they decided to put on there. So now I feel like that just sparked my curiosity.
Yeah, I would stop and go back and look at the cover for a few minutes. I thought it was really cool. But I also learned a lot, I'm sure you did too, about NAGPRA.
Had very little working knowledge at all of what that was.
Same. So NAGPRA stands for Native American Graves Protection and Repatriation Act. I did have to write that down, because that's a lot to remember. And not only did I learn like what that was, and that it's, you know, the government's attempt to get these artifacts and the remains back to their tribes, but also just how shady like museums and universities are.
And also, like, I think NAGPRA maybe had maybe it had good intentions, who really knows, but like it leaves too much. You could tell from the book that it leaves way too much room for loopholes and for, you know, institutions to give indigenous tribes the runaround, basically.
Right. And we do see that a lot in the book, just all of the efforts that collectors, both private collectors and these universities and museums, are going to keep that, and it's all in the name of science.
Right.
And I thought it was interesting that some of the quotes, because each week, because it goes week by week, and each week starts with a quote from an actual article or an interview or anything. And even Perry picked up on, well, how would you feel if we dug up, you know, your ancestors under the name of science? Because we want to measure their skulls, yeah, or we want to see what they were buried, yeah, with. And it was just kind of like, you know, like you said, I really had very minimal knowledge, yeah, if any, about this. And I love a book that makes me go and look things up.
Yes, no, definitely. It was definitely one of those.
Yeah. What did you think of Perry as a character?
Perry. So I think I loved her arc going from like chill, laid back slacker to like this activist. Mm-hmm. And seeing how passionate she became about something, because I feel like compared to Pauline, they're like complete opposites, right? So like Pauline's like an overachiever and she gets really anxious if she messes up and like all these things. And I think that seeing her arc, I guess, from like how she was at the beginning to like everything that she did to get to the heist, I guess.
Yeah, I thought it was also really interesting that Perry, you know, looks at, she's very laid back. She really, yeah, just wants to go fishing all, yeah, summer. Yep. And, but she's also very protective of people she cares, yeah, about. And mm-hmm. I think how she's always looking out for Pauline, and, you know, she's like, oh, like she rates Pauline's anxiety levels, yeah, based on what she's DEFCON, doing.
Yeah.
Yeah. DEFCON 1. Oh, we're at, yeah, DEFCON 3.
Yeah.
But I also thought it was interesting when she's with Shaunzi and her baby that she was like, we can't talk about like that because mm-hmm. the baby might take that in.
Yeah.
I was like, oh my, yeah, gosh, like I would never have,
yeah,
thought of, have, yeah, considered that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah. And I feel like there should have been some sense of moral ambiguity about like how Perry's going around.
Yeah.
Like with the heist and everything.
Yeah.
But I was like, no, go get, yeah, that stuff.
Right.
Like, let's do this.
Yes.
Let's go. But I also thought it talked a bit too, and again, if you've read Firekeeper's Daughter, mm-hmm. then you know this too, about the higher instance of crime against, yes, Native women.
The what a note about that.
I think they said it was like MMIW, murdered and missing Indigenous women.
Yeah, they the dichotomy, I think like the subplot, that was like a lot of the subplot, right? And I think like mm-hmm. the dichotomy between that and like the violence in the way of how their ancestors are been treated by being like dug up and basically stolen. I thought that the dichotomy was interesting.
I did too, that it's just like, it's still happening, yeah, that their ancestors can't even have a sense of peace. Mm-hmm. And I thought it was really interesting too, the discussion about how Perry's parents, and I think Cooper goes with them to talk to other tribes because their ancestors did not need a ritual,
right,
for reburying mm-hmm. People, or and so, and each tribe that they go to had something different.
Yeah,
and
it's almost doing,
yeah, that there's mm-hmm. a conversation now among these tribes about, okay, well how do we do this, how do we make, you know, things right within mm-hmm. our tribe to give, yeah, our ancestors peace. And, yeah, it was just, you know, when I read Firekeeper's Daughter, like I said, I heard Angeline Boulley speak, and I even told her this. I said, when I read Firekeeper's Daughter, I had to like put it down and not read anything,
yeah,
for a couple of days.
Yeah.
And I did the same thing with this one.
Yeah.
Like, it's a lot to soak in, yeah, but it's like I couldn't put it down either.
Yeah. I feel like it's because I just finished it last night, and I feel like it's one that's still kind of like marinating. Like, mm-hmm. I haven't fully even let it all sink in yet. So I feel like I'm going to have like lots more to say too, even after that,
yeah,
you know, after a few days.
I haven't even turned in the book yet. It's, yeah, it's still right here with me because I keep like going back, and I'll just like open it to a page and read it and just kind of reabsorb mm-hmm. it too. Like I said, I just, you know, so much information, some of it having read Firekeeper's Daughter I was aware of, but this one was, yeah, it was on a different level because it's a different situation, but it does have a lot of the same people. Mm-hmm. I, like I said, I thought Perry's growth, talked about that a minute ago, was really interesting. I thought it showed in the scene where she has dinner and the boy is over.
Oh, yeah.
Don't want to give away too many, yeah, spoilers. And Perry realizes that she could tease Pauline about it.
Yeah.
But she's like, you know what? There's more important things happening, yeah, right now. And I was like, mm-hmm. good for you.
Yeah.
I had like a very mom moment.
Yeah.
I was like, I'm proud of you.
Yes. Who else? God, there's so many characters I kind of want to talk about, but I feel like if we talk about them, we'll give too much away.
I know.
Well, I guess, were you surprised at the end?
Which part?
Like multiple parts. I guess
multiple parts. I was a little bit. I guess how by like everything one, tied together.
Yeah. Yes. It came full circle, and you're like, whoa. I was not expecting all those moving parts to be.
Yeah. You know. When Pauline sent that text at the end about this is it. And it was like at the same time Perrigo was like, oh, she's figured it out. Yeah. I was like, the same thing was in my head. I was like, oh my gosh, Pauline figured it out.
Yeah.
And then the thing happened, and it was like, oh, I didn't think it was that deep, but it all makes sense.
Yeah, definitely. It's.
But I also felt like Perry made a very good decision at the end. Mm-hmm. Like, it was, I think she found a good way to balance everything.
I did. I was very proud of her for that.
Yeah. I had like a little mom moment. I was like, again, I was like, I'm just proud of you.
Yeah. She was likable.
She really was.
I can see how she'll be unlikable to some people maybe, but I really loved her.
I did too. She's like, especially at that age, like what I wanted to be but could never be because I just didn't have that confidence.
Yeah.
But yeah, and I loved how protective she was. And I thought all the side characters were really well.
They were fleshed out. They were fleshed out.
Like, I loved Eric. I loved Shaunzi.
Love Shaunzi.
Yeah. Oh, gosh.
I also love Cooper. Like, I almost wish that he would have had like a little bit more page time because I really enjoyed him.
I do too. And I loved that he was just a big nerd and had all the Star Wars references, but was also like very deliberate.
Yes. And everything was very thought out. There was a reason for everything.
And I thought that was interesting too, how everything, you know, you have this one character who's like, do what it takes no matter the cost. And you have Cooper who's like, no, there's a process. And yes, it's slow, but it will come to fruition. And it's like, Perry's kind of like caught in the middle of that.
Yeah.
And I could very much see that happening in real life.
Yeah, 100%.
All right. So that was Warrior Girl Unearthed by Angeline Boulley. Obviously, Alex and I really liked it, and we could talk about this forever, but we'll wrap it up. We do have copies of Warrior Girl Unearthed available in our system that you can check out. We also have the ebook and e-audiobook on Libby. And for Firekeeper's Daughter, it really doesn't matter, by the way, which one you read first. I think you'll be good either way. And Angeline Boulley, when I saw her, said she actually wrote them that way. So you're good. But Firekeeper's Daughter, we do have as physical copies you can check out. We have the ebook and e-audiobook on Libby and the e-audiobook on Hoopla. So thanks for joining us this time. We will see y'all next month.
Bye.